So as chair of the trade committee, we are very happy that Holland was a proponent in the European trade agreement. It's going to be huge for both of us back and forth, both countries. We look forward to buying Dutch peppers, and we hope to, you know, Holland buys our great beef. I find that the biggest thing that Holland can contribute now to the world is the whole technology about environment and protection. We see how they protect themselves from the sea. United States and other countries have to get ready for this. It's happening. And I think Holland's going to be playing a huge role in environment and how to deal with the sea as the sea levels are rising. When the Dutch and the Canadians are sitting at these multilateral functions or organizations, people listen, which is pretty special.
Yeah, the trade relationship between Canada and Holland is very important, and Holland is one of the top three investors in Canada. Our top is market leader in the Netherlands, and at the time we were looking to expand internationally, and there were two main reasons to go for Canada. And the first reason was the economic circumstances. Canada mm-hmm. is a strong and large economy, and it ranks very high in the market potential index. And the second reason was that the cultures of Canada and the Netherlands are quite similar, and it's so much easier doing business in a culture that's comparable to your own.
And the key lessons that we took from Holland was in Amsterdam and surrounding areas, a car, you can get into town with a car, but you don't feel welcome there. It's very difficult to drive through those cities. However, your bicycle, you're the king of the road. Similarly, a pedestrian really rules the road. So our streetscape here, unlike most Canadian streetscapes, will look like a downtown European streetscape. We're even calling them Wernerfs, which I understand is a European word. We wanted to look at where are some of the most sustainable urban environments on the planet. We actually went to Europe, went to visit Rotterdam, went to visit Amsterdam, along with a number of other cities, and looked at a number of communities in Holland and others. And the Dutch are incredibly resourceful, living in very small amounts of land with very few resources, and yet have huge productivity. So a lot of good lessons learned from those visits.
The Dutch community is big here, like Ottawa, and just outside Ottawa it's about 9,000 people. The people that we have as a customer came here right after the war. So, and it was hard work raising kids, learning a new language, try to find getting settled in Canada, and a lot of them did extremely well. They never had the opportunity in the first 10 or 15 or 20 years to ever go back to Holland, but they had their Dutch store they could go to get their Dutch products, to speak Dutch to the people here. We have customers here that almost consider this a social gathering place. So this is more than just a store where you get your stuff.
My writing is Chatham Ken Leamington. It's the largest collection of greenhouses in North America. Now, pales in comparison with what I witness in Holland. I think Holland has 10 times the amount of greenhouses that we have. Nevertheless, because it's a cluster, when you have a cluster of industry, innovation starts to spawn. Now that innovation has already happened in the Netherlands, and they've done an incredible job with the greenhouse industry. I'm seeing a lot of people that really are moving forward, and I can see the day where what has happened in the Netherlands can start to happen in southwestern Ontario too and expand. There is a unique friendship between the Dutch and the Canadians. Of course, that stems from what happened in the Second World War, the liberation of Holland. But we share a lot of values as well, too. There's many things that are very common in our Dutch culture that are also common in our Canadian culture.
I moved to Canada for work and mostly for love. I met my husband while working in Italy for an international organization. And after a while, he convinced me to trade in Rome for Canada. He bought me Canada Goose to survive the Canadian winter, and so I went. A couple of times a year I visit the Netherlands, and it's great to be back home, but I always am also happy to come back home to Canada. I really feel proud now when I see the Canadian flag, and just to be part of this society as well.